Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another Deep Ogre review, the last Deep Ogre review of 2022. That rhymed. I didn't mean it to rhyme, but it did. Funny how life works out that way. My top 10 of 2022 is coming out early 2023, so stay tuned for that if you're wondering where that is. Other than that, let's get on with this amazing review of this amazing figure, Transformers Legacy Evolution Tarn. So for old Tarny Boy's accessories, you have his classic double fusion cannon with nice translucent pink plastic there, just absolutely vibrant. You can separate the pieces as well, and this is on a swivel, that's more for transformation with the tank mode. And you can combine these two weapons any which way you please. They both have ports on the bottom of them, and they both have handles on the bottom of them. So if you want to put it in that way, you can. If you want to put it in that way, you can also. So yeah, you can combine weapons, which I guess is what we're doing with Evolution, but we kind of already did that with Siege, so it's kind of confusing on what they're doing. Are they just doing the same thing again? I don't know, but it's definitely Tarn's gun, and it looks fantastic. Obviously, you can just plug that in on his arm any which way you please. There are two ports, so if you want to put them in any of them, you can. I'm trying to get this thing to rotate the way I need it to rotate. It's being a bitch. Hold on. So for detail, you have that amazing Tarn head sculpt with the Decepticon mask on him. Just absolutely, definitely, unmistakably Tarn here. Can't wait if we get to see the other DJD members, maybe in a box set sometime. But damn, Tarn just looks great. You have some light piping, which I'll put up an image right here. And it does look pretty good. It's not as good as some light piping, but at least it's light piping, especially nowadays. But you have a lot of clear, translucent purple plastic on this guy, like here, for his belly nipples, I don't know, gold Decepticon logo, which you don't see a lot. You don't see a lot of gold Decepticon logos, and I love it. Nice, deep, deep purple, and that lighter purple here. Just very beautiful silver all the way around, and more that light purple with that gray mostly for the legs, very very purpley crotch, nice gold for the knees, silver stripe right there, just absolutely amazing techno detail as well. Arrows, one of my favorite Transformers design tropes, just beautiful. Some vent things on the arm, just stunning stuff with this guy. Beautiful. I love the lines. I love the ridges on this guy. Just flat out amazing. This head sculpt is one of my favorite Transformers head sculpts we've ever seen. Character design and figure wise. So, oof. Sharp looking. And for articulation, you have a ball joint up at the head. He can look up about that far, down about that far, and a little bit of tilt. Arm can go full 360. Up about that far. I know, I think I reviewed G-Axis and I put it up. I know I reviewed him. I don't know if I uploaded it. But I know I said in that review that this type of arm joint annoys me. But with Tarn, it doesn't really annoy me as much, because there was no way, with the transformation the way it is, that they were going to be able to put the hinge in this tread. So I understand why they put the hinge here. It's a pet peeve of mine. Swivel right there. Transformation hinge, if you want to do that, I guess. Elbow, past 90, very good. Wrist, swivel. And one of my more modern Transformers favorites is finger articulation. Ooh, it started with Earthrise Optimus, and they just keep doing it, and they keep knocking out of the park every single time. I love that his fingernails are a little sharper, too. Just beautiful. Waist swivel, very nice waist swivel. Leg can kick up about that far, back about that far. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful all the way out. Thigh swivel, single jointed knee gets past 90 and more. Ankle pivot, and down and up. So, for comparison, here he is next to the tried and true Earthrise Optimus Prime. And they look really good together. I wish Tarn was a little bit taller, at least Optimus's height, but I understand why he's not. And here he is next to the Transformers Kingdom Cyclonus. Both of these figures have reviews, but older reviews if you want to go have a nostalgia blast for Matty Gwynn's past. And here he is next to some other Legacy Decepticons. Here he is next to Jaxus and Sky... I almost called him Skytread. Blitzwing. And these guys look absolutely amazing together, especially Tarn and Blitzwing here. Just beautiful, mean motherfuckers. And here he is next to some other Decepticons with the Coronation / Earthrise Starscream and the Transformers Legacy Velocitron. Who is he? Scourge. I almost said Black Convoy. I mean, I'm not wrong either way, but still. Reviews up for these two also if you want to go check them out. And last but not least, here he is next to some IDW-centric designs to go along with Tarn, the Transformers Thrilling 30 Springer, and the Transformers Generations Drift. If you want to go check those out, these also have reviews. For Robot Mode, I really like the size, I like the detail, I like the sculpt, I love the articulation. Just everything about this guy is perfect. Absolutely, positively perfect. I wouldn't say the best modern Transformer, maybe, but it's definitely in the top five best of the past 4 years. So without further ado, I'll get into transformation, and then my final... So, yeah, tank mode is kind of frustrating a little bit to get to, but other than that, it's just a pancake transformation. You flatten him out, put his legs over him, done. It's easy. It's Tarn as a tank. You do get a little bit of articulation here if you want it. Obviously, the tread, or the, okay, well, it doesn't like to stay in, plugged in all the way, but... The tank piece does move, the turret, there you go, but it does not, again, like to stay plugged in all the way, and it pisses me off. Other than that, it's a tank, it's a space tank from Transformers. It's what you expect at this point. I really love the purples, but that's on the robot mode. I really love the treads, but again, that's on the robot mode. The only big complaint I have, other than it just being generic, is the hands are just sticking out right there. So, robots in disguise. Well, this isn't much of an Earth disguise, but you know what I mean. Just like... Real stealthy. I know the DJG's whole thing isn't stealth, but at the same time... Really? Tarn is supposed to have, like, an obsession with transforming and, like, has to get a new T-Cog every 2 weeks or some shit like that in the comics. So, having his hands out here just kind of, I don't know, it doesn't fit for me. Anyway, this thing looks good. It's just another tank transformation, and we're pretty used to those, especially in Legacy. But, I'll get this guy back into robot mode, and I'll give out my final thoughts. So, for my final thoughts on this Legacy Tarn, I think people need this figure. Even if you don't like IDW, this figure has a great design, great articulation, great sculpt. Annoying at times transformation, but you get the hang of it eventually. Just fucking beautiful. Beautiful. Finger articulation, which, granted, we do get a lot nowadays, but... It's pretty rare when we do get it, and it is always amazing when we do. Just the absolute presence of this figure. I love the clear plastic on this guy. It really adds to the evilness of this. I love that they have light piping, although it is a little bit of light piping nonetheless. I love the gold accents they have on his feet, on his knees, and I die for the gold Decepticon logo every time I see it. So, yeah, I'm going to give this guy just between you and me, 10.5 out of 10. That's right, 10.5 out of 10. Goddamn amazing figure. I highly, highly, highly recommend it. Anyway, guys, if you like this video, leave a like. If you want to see more and you haven't already, subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one. And have a happy new year. See you, everyone.
New shit! New Kung Fu Kitty!
I got so many theories and suspicions. I'm diagnosed with real nigga conditions. Today is the day I follow my intuition. Keep the family close, get money for bitches. I double parked the Austin in the red. My mama told me that I'ma work myself to death. My girl told me don't let these hoes get in my head. My world been ecstatic, I checked the signal, they're red. Buzzing, radars is buzzing. Yeah, yeah.
And the pain.